Now the source is moving. Here now we have to discuss if the source is at a stationary and observer is moving. Now in the second case, the observer is moving and the source is at rest. Source is at rest. For this same thing we have to discuss. The observer is moving and source is at rest. Here, if the observer is moving and source is at rest, then this is also as like before. Here, the Tn plus 1 minus T1. Here, I am taking directly the wave, that is n plus 1th wave, the crest is reaching the observer. That is here source is at rest and observer is moving. When this source produces the crest and when the observer is moving with the velocity with the speed v naught, then the directly we are writing Tn plus 1 minus T1. This we can write directly, that is equal to n T naught minus n into v naught T naught by Vs v naught plus v. Here this v naught plus v is the relative velocity. This v naught plus v is the relative velocity, that is n T naught minus n v naught by v naught plus v. Here if we write the period, if we write the period, T is equal to directly will get that means divided by the n will get directly the 1 plus v naught by v. Directly we will get this v naught by v we will get. Now if we write the frequency, if we write the frequency, that is nu is equal to nu naught into 1 plus v naught by v we will get. This is the frequency of the wave when the observer is moving and the source is at rest. It is nu is equal to nu naught into 1 plus v naught by v. This is the observer is moving and the source is at rest. Now here next case, the source is moving and also the observer is also moving. For this source is moving and observer is also moving, then here this is the observer and this is the source, and the distance between this source and observer is L. Then here this is observer, this is a source. Here this observer is moving with the speed V naught and the source is moving with the speed Vs. Then here Tn plus 1 and the Tn plus 1 and T1, that is directly Tn plus 1 minus T1, the time interval. Directly we are writing the time interval, that is Nt0 plus L into Nt0 plus L into that is L plus N Vs minus V0 by Vs plus V0. Okay. Here nt naught plus L plus n into Vs minus V naught by Vs plus V naught and by V minus V plus Vs. Here this V plus Vs is the relative velocity and this V plus Vs is the relative velocity, that is V plus V naught. This V plus V naught is the relative velocity of the observer. Then by this we'll get, okay, here by V plus V naught. Now by this if we write the period, if we write period, then T is equal to T naught into 1 plus this 1 plus Vs minus V naught by Vs plus V naught we will get. Here if we write this directly, then that is V plus V naught we will get. That is T is equal to T naught into 1 plus Vs minus V naught by V plus V naught. This is the period. And this equal to, we can write T naught into, this equal to T naught into, we can write V plus Vs. It is a, if we take LCM, then V plus V naught plus Vs minus V naught by V plus V naught. Now this V naught cancel, then T naught into V plus Vs by V plus V naught we will get. This is a period T is equal to T naught into 1 V plus Vs by V plus V naught. Now if we write this reciprocal, we'll get the frequency nu is equal to nu naught into V plus V naught by V plus Vs. This is the frequency of the wave when the observer is moving and also the source is moving. That is nu is equal to nu naught into V plus V naught by V plus Vs. This is the frequency for the source is moving and observer is also moving. Here simply Doppler effect. For this Doppler effect, there are three cases or the three situation: observer is at rest and source is moving, observer is moving and source is at rest, and source is moving and observer is also moving. For that, nu is equal to nu naught into 1 plus V naught by V, and nu is equal to nu naught into V plus V naught by V plus Vs. This is the frequency for the Doppler effect.